Wednesday night, where we close. So, when we set up chairs back there, it was because it was still sunny. So come on up a little bit, at least up to the sidewalk area. And we are so glad you're here for our first Wednesday night worship outside. Where we can all sing. Refresh our souls and feel your presence among us, between us and within us. We ask that you will fill our hearts with your love, peace, and joy as we raise our songs to you together. We pray this in your glorious holy name. Let all God's people say, amen.
Amen.
Speaking of, all the people said amen. Next, we sing out.
You are lonely when you
been together in a while. I haven't forgotten. This one is good.
Thank you. And good evening to everybody online. I know we usually have a really good number on Wednesday nights, and I shared with people last night that we would be online tonight for this service. So it's a little bright, so I'm going to put on my sunglasses so I can see. And I don't look like I'm squinting the whole time. So I chose another song too, because I was also thinking about summer. We are in the, we're not quite in summer yet. It's still spring technically by the calendar, but it's unofficially summer, right? As soon as school gets out, it's summer. And I passed out paper to everybody here, and if you are watching, wherever you may be, if you have a piece of paper, I'm going to ask you a few questions tonight, so I want to get you ready for summer. So I want you to think about a few things. And the scripture that I'm using, it came right to my mind. It's another psalm, a little piece, and I will also talk a little bit about, I think that was Psalm 150 last, and talk about that a minute too, but I have questions for you all tonight. So so I'm going to read from Psalm 34, verses 1 to 8. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Look to him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed. This poor soul cried and was heard by the Lord and was saved from every trouble. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. And this was the verse that I want to talk about a little bit more tonight. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in him. Here ends the reading. So I was thinking about this service tonight and thinking about summer and being outside for worship, and the scripture that came to my mind was taste and see that the Lord is good. And I always find that kind of interesting. It's like, okay, well, how are we tasting? What are we tasting to see that the Lord is good? And it made me think about summer. So here's your first question right down. What is your favorite memory of what you'd like to do? If you're younger, you can say now. Your favorite memory of what you like to do in the summertime. And if you don't do it now, it's okay. If you're like, well, I'm too old, or I'm too grown up, or whatever, you know. What is a favorite thing you like to do in the summertime? Because you're out of school, you're hanging out, you like to go swim. I know, Laura, she probably likes to go swim. She likes to swim all the time.
Even as a kid. You know, we go to my aunt's house.
But, yeah. So, yeah, so maybe a special trip. Yeah, for us, we would travel, we'd get in our car. This was in the days before people had seatbelts, that's how old I am. Mm-hmm. Or we had them and we didn't wear them, and my dad had made this big thing in the back that we could lay down on it and take a nap as we drove cross country every summer. And that was one of my favorite memories. And I was telling somebody this last week that as we traveled, and the Iowans here, if we went to a town that had a capital, we always went to visit the Capitol. And I remember going to the Iowa Capitol when we rode the train for the first time as a kid, because my dad was afraid Amtrak was going to go out of business. So that was one of those times when the government threatened to shut it down. So we drove from Illinois to Iowa, and we got on the train and we went out to Colorado for the first time. And that is a favorite memory, because Colorado is so beautiful. If you haven't been, I think summer is one of the most glorious times to go to Colorado. It's just so, so gorgeous. Okay, number two, what is your favorite foods that you can't eat any other time as fresh? So yeah, we can eat a lot of things now that we maybe couldn't when we were growing up all the time. But what is your favorite fresh food to eat in the summer? You can name at least two.
That's right.
But more, yeah. You know, so one of my favorite things is Samuel and I go pick blueberries. In another week or so, the blueberry patch that we go to, it's called Blueberry Hill. It's on 20, almost to Route 212. And the gentleman has had it for over 20 years, and he lets it grow. He doesn't do a whole lot to it. He leaves it to God, like we were talking about the seed sower last Sunday. He leaves it, and I drive by it, and I wait for the sign to go up that says, Blueberry Hill is open. So that's a favorite memory of mine. And then we make all kinds of things blueberry coffee, lemon coffee cake. I want to make blueberry pie this year. Samuel likes to make crust, so I'm going to challenge him to make a crust. So, and the other thing I really love, I love corn. Anybody love corn? Yeah. And I will say, peaches are a Georgia thing, Midwesterner. I find some of the best corn is in the Midwest. But I also love tomatoes. Anybody love tomatoes in the summertime?
Yeah.
Especially fresh tomatoes, yeah. So I like to make fresh tomato sauce in the crock pot. I just take, cut up the tomatoes, wash them, cut them up, skin it all on, and I make a big pot of sauce and I put some away so that in the winter I can remember summer, right? All right, so the next question is, what's something you want to do this summer? Whether it's something you've done before, if it's something new, that's really great. But what's something you look forward to doing this summer? What do you want to do this summer?
Slippery rock.
Yes, slippery rock.
Okay. Okay. We need to go.
All right.
We need to go.
Take, put on your list. Because what I'm going to tell you is,
we're
going to
take you
this
down
with you. And you're going to, and I want you to put it on your refrigerator or somewhere where you can see it. And I want you to try to do as many of these things as you can. The fourth thing is, where can you worship God outside that you don't normally worship God? You know, so like singing outside tonight make me think about, I've shared this a few times lately especially, is I worked in Yosemite National Park for 2 summers. I led worship outdoors. It was my favorite place to ever do worship. It was absolutely gorgeous and it was an amazing experience and I loved it so much I went back for the second summer. And I don't think anything will top that experience for me of working outside. It was just so, so very amazing. So, and if you don't normally worship God outside, I want you to challenge yourself this summer, whether you come here to worship with us for these weeks we're outside, or, you know, just make a plan to maybe come to our labyrinth here. And those of you in the area who are watching, we have a labyrinth. You can come and walk. Larry Schultz has cleaned it all up. It's ready to go. And well, I thought you, yeah. And so come, we have a wonderful labyrinth. You can come here at St. John. Don't have to be a part of the church. If you have a friend who wants to come with you, the sign is in the back. Come walk the labyrinth. If you don't know how to walk a labyrinth, let me know. I've walked many and I'd be glad to give you some hints on that. You don't have to try them, but you might. But I just want to challenge us to think about, you know, summer is a real, I love summer. Although I say fall is my favorite season, but I was thinking about summer, like, you know, what is some of the wonderful things we enjoy in the summer that we don't normally do? So one of my favorite things is lightning bugs. Or what's the other name?
Fireflies.
But I grew up calling them
lightning bugs.
In the Midwest, that's what I knew, was lightning bugs. And so I've only seen a few, and I really need to get outside more at night because I'm missing them.
We got tons by our house. I don't know.
You got a bunch by your house?
Tons. And bats.
I've only seen like 3.
Yeah, and bats.
I'm like really missing them.
Oh, wow.
And then what about cicadas? Who's heard the cicadas so far?
I hate them.
Yeah. And where I live now, there's trees, there's pear trees and apple trees, and there's a blueberry patch right across the road from where I live. And at night, it sounds like hundreds of frogs are croaking their praise to God on any given night. If I go stand outside, I can hear the frogs. Okay, so here's another thing I want you to think about. How many of you last went out and looked at the moon at night? Like just went out for 5 minutes and stood there, okay? So that's a challenge for this summer. Pick once a month that you're gonna just go outside, maybe watch the sunset, and then see the moon come up in the stars. And a date for you, and school will be back in, and it'll depend on the weather, but around August 11th, 12th, every year, does anybody know what happens?
The meteor shower.
It's the meteor shower.
It's always, my brother's birthday is August 12th. I will be in Kansas City to celebrate his big birthday. So Tim, I don't know if you're watching, because you have a Wednesday night thing too, but you watch the last one. But we're going to have to check the meteor shower, because I'm flying in on August 11th for his birthday. So mark your calendars, because it's just gorgeous. Taste and see that the Lord is good. So let us give thanks this summer for God's bounty, for all the wonderful things we enjoy in the summer. Maybe make a recipe, try something new. Do you ever cook anything? Make anything new? Marilyn, you
still
make anything?
I am.
Once in a while.
I do it all the time, but I ended up eating it all myself.
Aubrey's a good
one. You like to make new things,
yeah,
Aubrey?
Makes new things. Yeah.
Well, my grandma always made, my grandma Olive always made blackberry pie, and I've never been a pie maker. I make quiche and
stuff like that, but I decided that this year we're going to try pie. We're going to try Samuel. I don't make crust, but Samuel makes crust, so.
Pillsbury makes some
he's
great.
Gonna, they do. I use Pillsbury crust. It's great.
Yeah, the ones that you
it's
roll
great,
out
but,
there.
You know,
there
I want to challenge myself a little bit, so I'm going to try to make a crust this year. We'll see how I do. And I want to make a blueberry pie. So try something new. And if you have an ice cream machine that you haven't used in a while, this is your reminder. Get it out. Make some ice cream. Have somebody over. Take your favorite fresh fruit. Try, I don't know if you can make rice ice cream. I've never tried to make, you know, something different, you know.
Rice?
For those who don't like milk ice cream, you know, try something new. But when you do all this, give thanks to God. When you sing, as we are singing, when you make food, when you go to a strawberry farm, when you pick these things, taste and see that the Lord is good. Give thanks for the many blessings of our lives. And I'm thankful tonight for Gail, for all the musicians, for us coming together. I'm thankful for those who are gathered here. I'm thankful for those of you online. And I pray that as we begin the summer, my last word to you is remember, if you go on a trip, God goes with you. You may not step inside a church, but you can still praise Him wherever you are. And if you do go visit a church and you come back to church, bring the bulletin, because I always like to see what other churches are up to. Have a great summer. We hope we'll see you here on Sundays at 10 o'clock, Wednesday nights at 7. Devotions continue tomorrow night on Thursday at 7 o'clock on Facebook, Eastern Standard Time, and Friday Fun Night also is on Friday at 7 p.m. And now we continue with our service.
So please stand if you were brand new. Did you just done?
Thank you.
Jesus, our risen Savior, as you send us into the world, guard us from the power of evil. Keep us in unity with all your people, and by your Spirit, move us to testify to your grace in our words and actions. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.